70s and as you run, people shine in and out of the building at droves. They don't have IDs anyone in after 6 o'clock out of the sheet, and again when they leave. There's not sure anybody signing out around the time Mr. Reddick left, and they'll sign out until 10 minutes later.
This doesn't say which offices have the people went to.
Some of them didn't even sign up. Phone rings, I can't do 6 things a month. Was anybody with Mr. Reddick when he went out? He was by himself. I offered to get a cab and was freezing out, but he said I should stay warm. He's a guy. Did you see him get in the cab? I saw him pull up. I remember because there were a few other people out there, like he was talking to one of them. I looked again, the cab was gone, so it was Mr. Reddick.
So you didn't see if Mr. Reddick got in the taxi by himself?
I wasn't paying close attention. Do you remember what this person looked like, the one that Reddick was talking to? A white guy. Suit and tie, overcoat, that's about it.
Thanks.
So he leaves his office at 7:30 and winds up dead 5 blocks from home a half hour late.
Canvas didn't turn up any witnesses in the vicinity of the attack.
The ballistics said the gun used to kill Mr. Reddick was a Glock 9mm. Anything recovered from the search of the area?
Nothing so far. And there were a couple gear shops and floors in the area.
So if his wife was right about him stopping for an anniversary present, he never made it again.
Wallet full of cash, nothing taken. It's still good, but a robbery, somebody comes along and they scare the attacker off.
So we're right back to the last people who saw him alive.
Security guard said Reddick left the building alone and was talking to a white guy in a suit just before he got into the cab. Only he wasn't sure if this guy got in the cab with Reddick.
Now, that lawyer you spoke with, didn't say there were other people at the meeting? Well, maybe this guy in the suit was one of them. Mr. Reddick left by himself.
He didn't offer to maybe share a cab with anybody.
Well, the rest of us continue working on the cases.
Lawsuits. Are those there?
Yes.
Mind if we take a look?
Actually, all those files are privileged.
Okay. Can you tell us the nature of the litigations?
They run the gamut. Slip and falls to contract disputes, like sexual harassment suits.
There's a point they have to come from. Were there any plaintiffs that were a problem?
They're all a problem. But it wouldn't have been in anyone's interest to harm Thomas. He was the one anxious to dispose of the suits.
Well, what we're thinking is, would anybody on this list have been interested in disposing of him?
I filed the suit because as a stockholder, I disagree with the management decisions of the company.
So I'm guessing you're a minority shareholder.
I'm trying to express my views. Please don't leave how much you pay.
Maybe you wanted to express your views directly to Thomas Reddick.
That's why I assumed. That's for killing.
Look, we spoke to the lawyers of the publishing company. They got a whole stack of letters that you wrote to Mr. Reddick. Threatening letters or what?
Look, I believe in the pen, not the sword. In fact, I got a file cabinet full of complaint letters just like the one I sent to the pavilion.
I have no problem believing that. So what the hell are you so upset about?
The pavilion's expanding into areas I don't think are in its best interest.
Such as?
Porn. I mean, they were softcore magazines, but buying them out was a fundamental violation of Pavilion's corporation.
The guy sells chippendales, but he objects to porn. I wonder why Pavilion's lawyers never mentioned it.
It's their dirty little secret.
Profitable one.
You know, we could cross-reference the list of plaintiffs from the magazine and see what turns up.
My agent told me it was a way to make some money.
You need those to finish first.
Rent, acting classes, time off for auditions. It all takes money, detective. Money I don't have.
So, why did you sue? Because your boyfriend didn't let you?
Doug doesn't understand what it's like, how much competition there is out there.
Look, he's the one who didn't want the photos published.
Well, they were supposed to be for a private collection. Then about 6 months ago, I got a letter in the mail saying they were going to run them with one of their magazines.
Why did Doug get that?
Is
there any chance that your boyfriend could have known Pavilion was going to talk about your lawsuit that night?
Why?
We just need to speak to anybody that might have been involved.
Look, Doug was pissed, but that's all. He couldn't have had anything to do with it. He works two jobs. Nights he tends bar.
Doug never showed up that night. Same line?
Same guy. Been doing it every year. I gotta cut him some slack, you know? I guess I'll talk to him tonight.
His girlfriend.
Come here.
You know what?
Yeah, sure, she comes here all the time. Oh, that may be something stupid, that day.
Why do you say that?
President.
That kid's upset, you know? I mean, this girl is a girl who's dreams. We can all remember what that's like. You know, it's called fictitious comes out. Yeah. He talked about it. Yeah, sure, it's all he could talk about. I tried to tell him, I said, look, it's not the end of the world or anything. But he didn't see it that way now.
Anderson.
That's right.
We need to talk to you about Thomas Reddick.
What about?
You don't seem surprised.
Well, I figured that's something to do with Amanda.
Then you know Mr. Reddick.
I know who he is, yeah.
Because the last time you saw him,
I've never seen him. What's it all about?
Maybe we better talk down at the precinct.
Are you saying I gotta go with you?
Look.
Oh, man, that hurts.
Can I have this change? Oh, don't worry about it. The guy picked you a good check in order to bring it back up. Let's go.
No artificial flavors, colors, sweeteners, preservatives. No artificial smells. Because cream dressings taste Panera, food is specialty.
Okay. Okay, I'll leave you guys alone now.
Working out like this reminds me of my days as an athlete.
Thank you.
And my gym.